Hey everybody, it's Eric Johnson from Air Tate Throws Nation. In today's video, we're going to break down some exciting news. Of course, if you haven't heard, Valerie Allman just broke the American record in the women's discus, 70-15. Huge congrats to Valerie and Coach Zeb Sion. They've been putting in a ton of work. Valerie looks amazing. The throw looks incredible, and we're going to break it down. Now, what we're going to do is let's take a look at it in full speed real quick, and you're going to notice that Val really sets up, tons of nice tension, comes through and just smashes the finish. Coach was fired up, rightfully so. You could see the trajectory of the, you know, flight of it just to the right of center. Really great throw, great alignment. And so what we're gonna do is kind of break that down, and what we'll do is put it in terms of what our system, we look at things in terms of six pillars. Again, the throwing chain reaction six pillar system, simply a way of learning and understanding the throw, being able to see something that happens so quick. If you notice when we just looked at this throw, Valerie, it's incredibly fast. That being said, the throw happens so quick, that's the point of our pillar system, so you can actually take what's happening in those, you know, 1.5 seconds and basically break it down. So now you see when we slow it down to half speed, you can start to see things a little bit better, but let's take a look at it in terms of breaking down each position and start a throw. Again, in our system, we talk about setting up actions, reactions. One of the things we talk about, we've done some YouTube videos, we talk about staying long. So the key thing is, you notice again, from this point on, she's just immediately long. We see this kind of length position. You're gonna see that she's also, this is in our view, right? If we look at the center line, you see how her center of mass is just to the right here, her left. And then that way, as she winds, that center of mass basically stays nice and centered up. Our pillar one objective is gonna be to set up the chain reaction. We wanna create length, we wanna create stretch reflex separation, and we're setting up our entry, right? So now you're gonna notice that Val does a really nice job. She's gonna get that, we call this pillar two. We're gonna call it setting up maximum power. We're really trying to get out and around that left leg, which she does exceptionally well. And one of the things that I love here is, again, look at that hip underneath that shoulder. This is what you see is pretty consistent with most elite world-class throwers, whether it's Daniel Stahl, Frederick Dakers, Sandra Perkovic, Jaime Perez. You know, you're gonna see kind of this thing. And again, when you start looking at 70 meter performances, you're gonna start seeing a lot more commonality things. You're gonna see a lot more things that they're doing across the board than you're gonna see different. And again, there's always gonna be the style differences, but one of the things we're looking at when we look at this throw as well is, these are our observations. We don't know what the coach and the athlete specifically are focusing on, but what we're looking at is those core mechanical positions. So now when you look here, again, you're gonna see what we would call this that pillar two. So we wanna be long, and when she comes from this position, I think this is what's key, is you're gonna notice she's got that arm straight. We're starting to see that left leg entry axis, everything moves around. We're gonna see the left arm is long, and you're gonna see that connection between the left arm and, you know, the sweep leg. And so as this goes long, she's gonna come in, and one of the things that you're gonna see is, as she's here, you're gonna notice that that arm, she's really pulling into the throw. This is what we refer to as our pillar three, dropping in, and you apply speed. You can't just drop down, you can't just go across, right? You have to drop in. It's a short sprint, you know, 4 foot to the middle of the circle. And if you look, when we look here, and we're in what we call is that pillar three, and we look at kind of the side view, you're gonna notice again that the knee is under the hip, everything's forward into the throw. Really love the position of her left foot, knee, and hip, right? We notice how everything's angled into the throw, but yet we have, it's more of a vertical line as well. So we're not sitting too straight, we're not too angled, she's just got that sweet spot. You're gonna, again, when you notice on the side, one of the things we always talk about is there's the counterbalance between the left arm and the sweep leg, and you're gonna notice that right here, her left arm doesn't really continue to open a whole lot, but her elbow and shoulder open. And this is one of the things we talk about as we're starting our transition, what we call is our pillar four. So when we're here in three, and then we go here in four, you're gonna notice how that the left arm is basically only bent at the elbow, so it provides a counterbalance system to the discus, right? And then when you look at it from the side, you're gonna see how we transition. You're gonna notice that she's got that discus basically at shoulder height. So she gets a really nice high point, which is going to be really critical to be able to create the proper angle over the delivery leg, right? And so one of the things that we kind of point out is when you look here, she is really got that discus just at shoulder height. So it's not much, you know, it's not like she's got this overly reaching high point. Now, again, I'd be really curious, and hopefully one day we'll get to talk to Val and Coach Cyan and see what's maybe some of their, you know, some of their key things that they're trying to do from a, you know, global perspective, and whether they think of elevating that arm. But she gets that arm, if you really look mechanically, it's really at just above the shoulder. And if you look here, you know, when you see that from the left shoulder to the discus, you're going to see that that discus is really just at or slightly above the shoulder. But because the entire body is on this angle, right, and if you look, that kind of goes through the spine line, through the head, and then if you look at the shin, you know, you're kind of more in this angle. You've got that parallel point. We always talk about the knee, the shin, and the back are going to kind of be parallel. And then you notice that she's actually, if we were to extend her arm out, you know, you would just see that she's in that nice T position. So the arm, while you're looking at a high point, and you go back and you look at this view and that discus seems so high, again, she's got the entire body on that angle. Now, when we go what we refer to as our pillar four, so we're transitioning, she's got that awesome counterbalance with the left elbow extended out, which is gonna help her keep her chest over the thigh, which is gonna help maintain that side angle we were kind of showing you. And now she's gonna really be lined up, really like this vertical line here. So this is enabling her, especially when we get to this position, which we call pillar five, you're gonna notice what we call is how everything's teed up, right? We see the vertical line here, we see the shoulders, we see the discus is way up here, and we see the block arm is actually just slightly below, right? Parallel or slightly below. So if we, sure, I can manipulate this a little bit, you see the arms kind of like this. So she's just got a ton of separation here. She's going to be able to pull on this discus all day long, which is what she does. So you can see right here, you can kind of look in the video. I love on the side view, you can really start to see that she's just smashing it. And it's really awesome. And you're going to notice that here again, we call this pillar five. We're locking down power. We're getting the feet down on the ground, both feet on the ground. We're getting the delivery side heel is elevating to push the knee and the hip this way, and then it rotates. It doesn't just rotate. It does this. So she pushes, and you can see right here, it pushes. The knee is definitely in front of the toe. That's pulling the hip. That's pulling the knee. And then what you're going to see is that block foot's down. She's going to just crush the block arm right there, and you're going to notice everything going forward. Some might say that she's coming off the ground a little early, but she's really pushed into the block leg, and that's what you're seeing with Frederick Dakers, Daniel Stahl, all these guys with their 70-meter throws. They have that block foot on the ground all the way through delivery. And I think the thing that's super impressive about Val's throw is that block foot is all the way on the ground and the discus is out of her hand, right? You can see right here on the side angle, right there as she comes out and the discus goes, block foot still on the ground. That's huge. Some people would say you're supposed to jump. I totally disagree with that. And I think this is more consistent with what the best throwers in the world are doing. And clearly Val is one of the best throwers in the world. World leader, American record holder, greatest American thrower ever. So you can just see that she's crushed it. The block arm, the block leg, super connected, and then everything's moving around and out into the throw. It was a great looking throw. And again, huge congrats to Valerie and her coach Zeb. At any rate, this is just what we kind of thought would be a cool way to be looking at things. Just break it down. It's huge news. Again, it's always great when a record goes, especially given the current landscape of this year. It's really exciting to think what she'll do when she gets back into a really competitive groove. And again, when you're in a stadium and all that kind of stuff in the hype of the Olympics, it would have been really exciting. She would have been basically competing at this time. So we'll look forward to next year, things getting back on track. But again, huge congrats to Valerie and Coach. And hopefully you guys enjoyed this. So again, if you like this, be sure to comment below, give us a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and we will see you guys on the next video.